Indianapolis, the Cavaliers' winning streaks are over thanks to Victor Oladipo and, more broadly, the three-pointer. The Indiana Pacers knocked off the Cavs 106-102 Friday night, stopping Cleveland's overall winning streak at 13 and its road streak at 7. A win for the Cavs would set franchise records for both. Oladipo scored 33 points, with 6 threes. The Pacers drained 15 three-pointers as a team. The Cavs, always such a dangerous team in the fourth quarter, especially from three-point range, made just 3 of 12 attempts beyond the arc in the final period. Cleveland's 39 points in the second half was its lowest scoring half this. The Cavs shot 0.351 from the field in the last two quarters. LeBron James led the Cavs 188 with 29 points, 12 rebounds and 8 assists. Kevin Love added 20 points but shot 6 of 16. J.R. Smith made all three of Cleveland's three-pointers in the fourth quarter and finished with 15 points. His desperation three in the corner with 10 seconds left cut the Pacers' lead to 104-102. The Cavs shot 11 of 36 from three-point overall and the Pacers outscored them 19-4 on the fast break. Cleveland scored just 1 point over the first 555 of the fourth quarter. Jose Calderon and Dwayne Wade each scored 9 points. We miss shots, James shots. Kyle Korver missed three open threes. Has he done that since the streak started? Nope. J.R. missed two open threes. I missed some shots. We executed the offense, especially to start that fourth. We did have two 24-second shot clock violations that we didn't like, but our guys who we got the ball to in the fourth quarter got some really good looks. Just didn't make them go down. The Cavs shot 11 of 36 from three-point overall and the Pacers outscored them 19-4 on the fast break. This is Cleveland's first loss since the Rockets beat them November 9. The Cavs' streak of consecutive games with at least 100 points is now at 19. Just showed that we're capable of playing Cavaliers basketball, Cavs coach Tyronn Lue said of the no-finished winning streak. Got a very confident unit and tonight, we talked about it in the locker room, gotta start a new streak. It was a good streak and came in here and got beat. The Pacers 15-11 had 5 players score in double figures, including Miles Turner with 15. The Pacers blew the Cavs out in Cleveland on November 1, 124,107, behind 16 three-pointers. Indiana entered play second in the NBA in three-point percentage 0.395 and is now 112 when making at least 10 threes. Oladipo scored 20 in the third quarter, making 7 of his 8 shots to help Indiana forge an 8,986 lead heading into the fourth. His three-pointer with 101 left in the game put the Pacers ahead by 6. I thought he made some shots off the dribble, hit a couple threes off the dribble and that opened up his drive because he had to get closer to him, Cavs coach Tyronn Lue said. He got into the paint and got some foul calls, and, I mean, he just had it going. Like I told you before the game, he's playing well. Korver entered play leading the NBA with 31 threes in the fourth quarter. He missed all three of his three-point attempts all in the fourth on Friday and finished with 3 points total. It was a rare bad night for Cleveland's bench. None of the reserves had a positive plus-minus number, and the Cavs were outscored by 17 when Jeff Green was on the court and by 12 while Wade was out there. The Cavs fell behind 132 to start the game but clawed back for a 3,231 lead at the end of the quarter. James and Love combined for 22 of those points. Cleveland extended its lead to 6,357 at halftime. The play of the half came courtesy of Calderon, who was back on the court for the close of the second quarter, a rarity, and lobbed a long alley-oop to James for a dunk with 220 left. James hung on the rim, kicking his legs like he was on monkey bars, as the Pacers called timeout. On Cleveland's next possession, James rifled a pass to Calderon for a three-pointer. Next, the Cavs play again Saturday when they host the Philadelphia 76ers at 8 p.m.